Look, I'm not going to go out and fully say that Minnesota is a very good team, but you can at least agree with me that until last night, they were a very hot team. Avs ain't having none of that. Avs win 5-1 over the Minnesota Wild.
Oh my goodness gracious! Wasn't it time? Score! Justice is served!
Expectations are a funny thing because they can change so quickly. I think most people expected the Avs to dominate against weaker teams in the division like Arizona, LA, Anaheim, that type of thing. But you look at the standings and you see Minnesota pushing towards the top of the division. And while you do still think the Avs are the better team on paper, I don't think many people expected them to be this dominant against them. I'm sorry, but this game was never close. It was never all Minnesota's right there, despite the score being close for a good portion of it. The play on the ice was just completely lopsided. At one point, shots were 21-1 in the Avs' favor. And that is in the first period. That's how ridiculous things got. And the thing about this game, if you don't believe the dam breaks, believe it after this one, because not only did the Avs dominate, they got puck luck as well. Probably earned, for sure, but you'll see what I mean on this first goal. Mikko working out from behind the net is eventually going to get it up high to the point to McKinnon, who is playing high in that spot that he loves, but we see something a little bit different, and I love the concept of this play. McKinnon gets the puck up high, initially looking to shoot, but then decides to dangle, beats one, and then that one, you know what, strong on his stick, fine, good play. But he absolutely ends Ryan Hartman, just makes him look like a complete fool with a crossbody dangle, just pulls it back enough to get around the stick. And Ryan Hartman, look at that, one little move has created, what is that, 6, 7, 8 feet of space between the two of them? I mean, just absolutely an ankle assassination right there. That gives room for McKinnon to walk in, Rantanen coming alongside with him, trying to create another option. That was ridiculously good hockey. And then here, McKinnon gets lucky. You see there, he tried to pass it across to Rantanen. It goes off the defender's stick, flubs up into the air and towards the net. Reading it is Talbot. He read the pass well, so he goes over to cover Rantanen. Didn't read the deflection. He opens up his five-hole wide, puck flying through there. Landy takes a whack at it, but he misses it entirely. And the puck just trickles through his five-hole. When you're lucky and good, it's easy to score goals. Hockey's fun sometimes when things are going your way, especially when you're earning the things going your way. The top line definitely earned it in this one. They were absolutely dominant. They weren't even done in the first period. Their next goal is honestly probably the prettiest goal of the year, at least for the Avs. All right, you can't write up plays better than this. It's the first line, but it's also Belmar taking the faceoff. Right now, Rantanen is on the bench, so Belmar can take the faceoff. Belmar wins it back, set play. Girard comes back and collects it and then just lobs it. Forsberg to Blake style, football pass over the top to the middle of the ice. It's Landeskog who tracks it down initially, and check this skill out. Knocks this puck down out of midair with a little bit of a tip, goes through the defender's legs, and allows Nathan McKinnon to pick it up. Now you can just barely see up high. This is Mikko Rantanen jumping onto the ice as Belmar is getting off to get the true top line all together, and Rantanen is just going to sprint to the far post as soon as he steps on the ice. McKinnon's going to pull up here, do the thing that he loves to do, waits, so patient, drops it off to Sam Girard, who's streaking in on the near side. There's Mikko streaking in on the far side. Everybody's going to beat their men to their spots. Girard with full speed, Mikko the sneaky boy, gets past three of them, wide open lane there, you can see, sticks, maybe a touch in the way, but this play came together perfectly, and Mikko makes it count with the tap-in. All those plays, all those moments where you're thinking, oh man, the Avs are being way too cute, it's almost worth it when they score goals like that. This game continued to be an absolute roasting of the Minnesota Man-Bear Pig at 5-on-5 top to bottom. It was just complete domination. The only mistake the Avs made is they took a few too many penalties, and a couple of the calls were questionable, yes, but Avs have got to find a way to stay out of the box. You get away with it against a team like Minnesota. Against a team like Vegas, it's going to hurt you. I mean, that isn't even true. They didn't get away with it against Minnesota. The only reason Minnesota has a goal in this game is because of Avs penalties. Look, this is a great play from Victor Rask here as he picks up this puck in the back end, gets with speed through the neutral zone. Logan O'Connor going to challenge him. Rask, strong on his stick, just skates by him. Nothing to that. Gerard, look, I understand what he's doing here. He's taking away the pass on the near side. Minnesota has two guys stacked there. Don't really have a problem with how he plays this, but it does open up room for Rask to cut to the middle, and that's exactly what he does. And then you have Ryan Graves, indecisive in the middle of the ice. He initially stops and gets ready to challenge Rask, but then gets worried about getting blown past, so starts to scoot backwards a bit more. Puts himself in a spot where there's nothing he can really do. Doesn't have the reach for his stick to challenge Rask, and doesn't have good position to really do anything at all to him. So Rask takes advantage of the space, walks in and fires a shot. Does a great job to put himself in this situation, and this is just a perfect shot. Grubauer gets beat up over the glove. Hard to argue against a shot like that. Again, you have to understand, the Avs do give up this one goal in this game, but they gave up four shots on the power play for Minnesota. They only faced 16 shots at 5-on-5. That is out of control dominance. Again, against a weak offensive team like Arizona, okay, maybe you can see that, but Minnesota has been rolling, and they just ran into an absolute brick wall in the Avs. While the penalty kill did get burned in this one, the Avs would get their own opportunities on the power play and get it back. Nothing too special about this play. I will say the Avs working it down low in behind the net on the power play instead of sticking to the perimeter umbrella on the outside here. More dangerous when you're closer to the net. Rantanen gets it on the near side. Landy picks it up. Is going to try initially, I believe, a pass to the middle here that, again, goes off of a Minnesota stick, bounces in towards the net. It's loose because it cannot get covered by Talbot. And then Landy, just Johnny on the spot on his own reboundish type thing here, jumps on it, lifts it enough to get it into the net. Again, hard work plus a bounce, and the Avs find the puck in the back of the net. It's a beautiful thing to watch. It's 3-1 after two periods. Shots are 44-13 after two periods. Just utter dominance. I've said it like six times, but what else can you call it? The Avs are just in a complete league of their own right now. This game is so ridiculously dominant, I haven't even mentioned that Cale, Makar, and Bowen Byram were back for this game. Certainly Makar helps on the power play. Byram was rock solid as well. What it really does is it gives the Avs more opportunity to spread the minutes out on their defense. You don't have to have Taves and Gerard playing absurd minutes on every single night. You can spread that out. Everyone's fresher, and it's just that much easier for the Avs. The Avs waste no time in the third. They get the dagger goal and pretty much flip it into cruise control from there. Minnesota's resetting with the puck here. They're going to work it to the far side and try to re-enter, and a bit of a flubbed puck just gets away from him. Great read by McDonald to quickly jump on the puck and just slap it out into space. Donskoy, the leading forward there, is able to win the race, jump on it, get a clean breakaway, and open up Cam Talbot like a can of sardines. Top end scoring, check. Power play scoring, check. Depth scoring, check. Elite defense, check. Quality goaltending as well, check. Bag it, tag it, we done here. Oh, one more thing. Is Mikko Rantanen the best player in the West Division? First of all, hard work from Landy, Graves, and Rantanen here to collect the puck that's kind of loose and scrambly and eventually get it out of the zone, even if it is a bit sloppy. Landy collects this one, gloves it down, and then gets it up the ice to where Rantanen can get to it. And Rantanen with sick stupid amounts of skill here. This puck is coming down. He's going to bat it out of midair to get it across the blue line onside and just whoop right around his man. I mean, that alone is stupid filth. You could stop the play right there and it deserves to be on the highlight reel, but he's not done. He goes to his backhand side, makes no bones about it. Everybody knows what's coming here, a backhand shot. Most players, this is going to be baby soft right to the chest. Mikko's top corner, over the shoulder, unreal. No one in the West Division has more points or goals than Mikko. Mikko's in top 10 in the entire league in both of those categories. He had a four-point night in this one. The man is the big moose, and he playing like it right now. A little bit of health, a little bit of puck luck, sprinkle it all together with a quality hockey team, and the Avs are there. You're witnessing the contender Avalanche. That is the end of this game video review. The Avs just keep on rolling. Be sure to check out all the other DNVR post-game content and other coverage as well. I am Rudo, and Minnesota, when are you going to figure out you have your logo on backwards?
Avalanche time, come on, grab your friends. We're going to the playoffs again with Nate the Dog and Gabe the Babe. The fun isn't over yet, it is Avalanche time.